So let's take some time and talk about how you can deploy these displays once you've built them. When you build a new display in Coresight, it gets assigned a generic name. So the first thing that's always a good idea to do is to give it a unique name that means something about what you're looking at. So for this particular display, I might call it boiler display or boiler trends or something like that. So double click, I couldn't do that, so I'm going to just type in boiler trends. And when I hit enter, you'll notice that the URL for this particular display updates. So this is now a unique URL. Each display with PI Coresight gets its own URL. So you can actually take these URLs and copy them and paste them in emails or chat windows and share them with your colleagues. Or you could even, if you had a read-only display that was something that everybody wanted to look at all the time, you might even make that a link on your homepage or something like that. But there's a couple of steps you have to take in order to make this shareable with your other users. The first step is you have to make it public. Now this display already is public. And there's two ways to make it public or to remove it from being public. The first way is by clicking the drop-down arrow next to the display name, you have a checkbox here. And if you take the public off, then you're the only person who can see this display. If you want to share this with others, then of course you have to enable public. And when you do that, you'll see the little globe icon is here. Now, if I click on the PI Coresight homepage link, Boiler Trends now has a little globe. So it is a public display. Again, I'll show you. We'll make a new display. We'll call it Cracking Process. And we'll make a table. So this is a brand new display. It's just got some information about the cracking process. I just give it a name. If I want to make this public, I can click the drop down and click the public button, and voila, it is public. Now there is another way to do that. If I go to the Coresight homepage, there is a button called Display Management, and when I click on that, I have the ability to make cracking process public from here. I can also make it read-only. You might have seen that in the drop down previously as well. By default, when you are sharing a display with other people and you've made it public, it's already read-only for them. They can't change it. But it's not read-only for you. So if you want to go back in and make other changes, those changes will be preserved. If, however, you want to make a display that is a static display, that no matter how you interact with it, it always comes back up the same way, you'll want to make that read-only for yourself as well. And that you can do that here, or you can do that in the drop-down next to the display name. From this display management screen, you can also delete any display that you own. And you can do that just by clicking the display name. So if I want to get rid of cracking process, I can click it here and click the little X, and now it is actually no longer. So we go back into Boiler Trends. I never ever clicked save. So if we go into one of these boilers, for example, and we get a couple of pieces of information, and we drag them onto the screen here as values. Okay, so now we have 5 values and 2 trends. I'm not clicking the save button, going to the Coresight homepage, going back to Boiler Trends, or the display we're just looking at. You'll know that it remembered my changes. If I come up here and make this read-only for myself, and add a few more pieces of information. Maybe we go back to a different boiler, boiler 235, and get burner, fuel, gas flow, and water again, and put them here as values. So now we have 9 values on the screen. It's read-only, it's not gonna remember those new 4 values. So if I go back to the homepage, Boiler Trends, okay, so now this is what I had clicked and saved as read-only. Didn't actually save anything, but after I hit read-only, it's not allowing any other changes to the display for permanent use. Now, what if I want to interact with somebody else's display? For example, here's a display, Gauge and Trend, that I did not build. One of my colleagues built this. And if I click on it, You'll notice up at the top here it does say read only. Now I can interact with this however I want to, if I want to zoom in on the trend, if I want to lock it down, if I want to add some of my information in from the cracking process. Maybe I want to add a compressor here and a table. So I want to make some changes to this display. No matter what changes I make, because it's read-only, it won't remember them. I can interact with this, I can do whatever analysis I want. I could take his trend and add it to my cart. I certainly could do that also. This is boiler 209 trend. Okay, but none of these changes that I've made, aside from the cart, are going to be remembered because this is read-only. So if I go back to the home page and look at gauge and trend, you'll see that it didn't remember those changes. So what I can do is I can make the changes that I want and add something else onto the screen here. And the way to preserve that is I have to rename this display. So this is gauge, table, and trend. When I click hit enter, now it has a new URL. It's no longer public, but it's also no longer read-only. So now I can go ahead and share this with other people, or I can keep this for myself. But this is how I can interact with other people's displays. When I go back to the home page, though, the original gauge and trend display is still there. I haven't impacted that in any way. So that's a little bit about how you can deploy these Coresight displays once you've built them.